Okay, so we want to talk about derivatives of exponential functions. And so I'll just introduce these shortcuts, okay? So one, and we'll talk about how to do simple derivatives and then more complex, right? So if f of x is e to the x, the derivative of that, f prime of x, is also e to the x. Yeah. I know it's its own derivative. So, take a moment to take that in for just a second, and then we'll do some problems. Okay? So, example. So, let's say find f prime for f of x equal to x squared e to the x. Right? Okay, I have to use the product rule here because I have two things multiplied together right there, and I'll take the derivatives. Okay, so this first one, f is x squared, f prime is 2x, and g is e to the x, and g prime is e to the x, right? So f times g prime plus g times f prime, and we get x squared e to the x plus e to the x times 2x. Okay? And really, you can factor this e to the x out, and maybe an x even, x squared plus 2x. I would factor out x e to the x and be left with x plus 2 if you're going to do something with this particular equation, like find where it's 0 or things like that. Okay? Okay. Oh, let's do one more example. Kind of like this. Find f prime for 1 plus e to the x to the fourth power, f of x equal to this function, right? Still, this is my general chain rule. This inside has to have this derivative, so I have f prime of x. So this is what I'm thinking. So I have this inside piece, right? Right there, that I think of as g to the x. And really, f of x has this form where I have g of x to the fourth, right? And I know the derivative of that should be, I bring this 4 out front, I leave the inside alone, right? Subtract 1 from the exponent, and then I have to multiply by g prime of x. Okay? So if my g of x is 1 plus e to the x, the derivative of that, the derivative of 1 is still 0, the derivative of e to the x is e to the x. Okay? So I get 4. This is the original inside. Times e to the x. So I probably write that as 4 e to the x, 1 plus e to the x cubed. Okay? Okay. Now, these sometimes do get more complicated, right? Especially when I have more than just x in the exponent. Okay? And I'll remind you of the general chain rule. Because that's what we'll use here to differentiate these. So if I have h of x is f of g of x, we said that the derivative of that was f prime of the inside times g prime of x. And this led to the general power rule, right? Okay. So the example that I want to do is f of x is equal to e to the, let's just say 5x. Okay, so here my function is this inside part. Let me name this h of x so we keep everything straight, right? That's the function I'm looking at. Okay, then this outside piece, this outside function f of x is e to the x, and this inside piece is this right here. That's inside this other function. So g of x is this function 5x. F prime, I know what that derivative is. It's e to the x, and g prime is just 5. So I'll use this general power rule, right? Not the general power rule, this general chain rule. Okay. So h prime of x is f prime of g of x times g prime of x. Okay? So this is f prime of what's g of x? 5x times 5. And f prime is e to the x. So I put 5x into e to the x and multiply by 5. So I get 5e to the 5x. Okay? We're going to do the same sort of thing for this other function. F of x is equal to e to the 3x squared plus 2x minus 7. Can you guys try this using the example we just did and then come back? Okay? Okay. So I'm going to look at this as like this is my, I'm going to reinterpret. This is my big H of x, right? To keep kind of these pieces the same, my outside function again, f of x is e to the x, and the derivative of that is e to the x. And this inside function g of x is 3x squared plus 2x minus 7, and g prime of x is equal to 6x plus 2. Right? Okay, so I want to go ahead, h prime of x is equal to f prime of g of x times g prime of x. So I get f prime of 3x squared plus 2x minus 7 times 6x plus 2, right? And f prime is e to the x, so I get e to everything in here times 6x plus 2. And I would probably move this 6x plus 2 to the front so that you can see what's happening. Something like that. Okay? Okay, that's derivative of exponents. Let me know if you have questions.